Hello again, Kyle here. Again. Let me tell you about the man I met when I was still young. Granted, I only met him less than a year ago when Grin and Capcom released the excellent Bionic Commando Rearmed, but the man made a lasting impression, mostly because of the huge metallic tendril sticking out of his shoulder. Grin remade the classic NES title in anticipation of the release of Bionic Commando for your fancy Xboxes and PlayStations. And now that he's here, we should have a little chat about him. Let me just get this out of the way right off. Who is this dick on the box? This dreadlock dirtbag is not the Bionic Commando. Trust me on this. The only way to play the game is to unlock the retro skin for your hero through the arcade game. The sunglasses, the bomber jacket, the cropped hair, it all fits. The other guy's a jerk. Alright, moving on. It's been some years after Nathan Rad Spencer, aka the Bionic Commando, and Super Joe Gibson, stick with me here, people, took down the Nazi regime, I'm sorry, the Imperial Forces. And now, the world has turned on bionic people. Sick of being made fun of, a pro-bionic terrorist group has bombed the crap out of Ascension City. Get it? Because you swing and climb with your arm in Ascension. Okay. Now on death row, Spencer's called back into bionic action, and you know what? There's more worst to get out of the way. This storyline is complete garbage. If you're looking for three-dimensional characters who say things outside of,
"This shit is starting to piss me off,"
look elsewhere. Someone gave all the angsty pills the Prince of Persia took for Warrior Within to the characters in this game. Dialogue tends to sound like this. Spencer: sarcasm, rude, fuck, angry, my wife! Super Joe: snark, snark, stoic soldier, snark. Military guy: grumble, annoyance, this is my operation, Spencer! Add on top of that two of the worst twists in storytelling history, and you've got something that begs you to shut it off. The only highlight is the return of Broder, who is so over the top you can't help but enjoy him. It's priceless. They took Dr. Strangelove and they put him in a video game. But that's not why I came here. I came here because underneath all of that is a really fun game. The main component of the game, of course, revolves around your huge robotic limb, swinging and climbing through a beautiful destroyed landscape. Once you get the hang of how to gain and maintain momentum, nothing's more exhilarating than crossing a dangerous cavern or a minefield with three deft swings. Except, perhaps, for the combat. You could use your guns like some sort of regular commando, but why? Why when you can punch a car into the air and then punch it again, sending it hurtling into a crowd of grunts? Why not eliminate that enemy across the room with a well-thrown rock, or yourself, or another enemy? Once the game finally allows you to access all of your arm grapply powers, you'll wonder why you ever thought a grenade launcher was cool in the first place. Could have used more boss fights, though. The other treat in this game, to me, are the challenges. Normally in today's video game landscape, challenges that lie outside of go here, shoot this, advance plot, only earn achievements or trophies. Not so in Bionic Commando. Killing four enemies at once with a well-placed grenade or taking out 50 guys with headshots will not only get your gamerscore points, but also unlock bonuses like faster reloads, more health, or better accuracy. I often found myself relishing the next enemy encounter, partly for the fun, and partly so I could complete another little challenge. These bonuses are definitely appreciated. This game is hard. Be prepared to fall to your death. A lot. You'll fall, you'll drown, you'll get sniped, you'll get beaten to death with sticks. I wouldn't mind it so much. I mean, it's Capcom. That means great gameplay, terrible stories, and hard games. But part of the game's difficulty comes from its very setup. Bionic Commando isn't an open world, it's comprised of stages. This means two unfortunate things. One, when you die, it's very likely you haven't reached a checkpoint in a while. Enjoy doing the level again. And two, load times become a bit of an issue. If you're looking for an immersive, complete world to swing around in for a good chunk of time, like Ultimate Spider-Man or Hulk Ultimate Destruction, you may wish to look somewhere else. If you can sit down, plow through a few stages, and then shut it off, you might enjoy it a bit more. The level-by-level, die-and-go-back-to-the-start style harkens back to Rearmed and its classic predecessor. You better get good at the game and fast, or you will be very frustrated. Also fast. The other contention with the level setup is that they're linear. Not a real problem in itself, but the stage area is maintained by making anything too far off the beaten path super radioactive. Launch yourself in the wrong direction with too much force, and you'll be dead before you knew what didn't hit you. It's a shame, but is it any worse than invisible walls? Yes, because those don't kill you. One final note, I really love the music in this game. Probably because I played Rearmed to death, but hearing all those little themes remastered or tweaked throughout the game is very enjoyable. It may sound like I have more grievances with this game than I do commendations, but that really isn't the case. I honestly just put it down and I want to turn it back on. The mechanics and gameplay are that fun. The multiplayer is fairly standard, despite the common course of action being swing away from danger rather than kill people with guns. It's fun, but I doubt it'll take the place of your Halos or Gears of Wars or even Red Factions. Like the Bionic Commando himself, you have to look past the surface for this game, with its silly story and its issues with difficulty and linearity, to find the wonderfully joyous center. You know, the joy that comes from swinging through an apocalyptic wasteland, grabbing someone with a cold, unfeeling robot hand, and slamming their head into the ground.